Okay, guys, sitting by the pool with the fam bam. Living your best life, want to tell you really quickly how to build a content strategy in just a hot second. I think people think this is a lot harder than it needs to be, but guess what, Mom?
It's not
that hard. If you know the right way to do it.
You know what, honestly, if you could have just done it like right when you got here, I don't even know what you're talking about.
Guys, listen to my mom, okay? Here's the thing though, I actually have a resource for you at the end if you hang around till the end to actually show you how to do this. But long story short, first thing you need to understand with a content strategy, I think the context for this, I think sometimes they're like, I talk about how to build a movement, and when your story becomes their story, then your solution becomes their solution. But the only way for that to happen is if you actually tell people your story. You can't expect people to adopt your story if you don't actually tell the story and tell the story over and over and over and over again. So I want to walk you through what this looks like. First and foremost, you need to know who you're actually talking to. If you don't know who you're talking to, then it's just noise. So if you know who you're talking to, actually, I'd love to hear, like, who is your who? Who is your person? Put it down in the comments. Because then after that, this is the framework that we go through every single month. We literally have a whole day that's planned. We call it monthly mapping meeting, where we hash this out. We think, one, what are the offers that we want to push those people to? So our who, where do we actually want to lead them? Once you know that, then we say, okay, cool. What are the false beliefs that might prohibit them from getting there? Vehicle false belief, internal false belief, external false belief. What's any thought that might come to their mind that might prohibit them from actually going where we want them to go? Then essentially we say, cool, what stories, design hacking, how to present stories that convert, what stories do we need to tell to break down those false beliefs? Literally start hashing out story after story after story. That becomes our content. More often than not, if you're just like, well, I don't have a video editing team, or I don't have all this stuff, just literally think, okay, cool. What is the most effective, efficient way that I could tell the story? If it's on a Facebook Live, go on a Facebook Live. If it's an edited video, make an edited video. It doesn't matter. But I think the important thing to understand is it's not about batched content. It's about how do you get your story out into the world in a way that will convert so that your story becomes their story and your solution becomes their solution. And starting with knowing who you're talking to, then knowing where you want to lead them, what false beliefs are there, and what stories you can tell to combat that will help 100%. So if you start looking at my content, literally go month by month and week by week, we usually try to do one false belief per week. You'll start to see what the false belief is. You'll be like, oh yeah, I guess that week they were talking about how design hacking's not just for funnels. You'll be like, oh yeah, okay, I can see how they did that, X, Y, Z. That's the framework. So listen, guys, if you want something cool to come to help you to be able to do that, it's going to be inside of my Facebook group. Click the link, subscribe, like, comment, share, tell us all the things. Anything else you want to say? Do you subscribe to my channel, Mom?
I sure do.
Do your YouTube channel?
Go off, queen. Go off.
Go best friend. Go best friend.
Subscribe to my channel.
That's my bestie right there.
How do you know I don't have